what's happening, guys? Back again, and we're doing a leg day. Usually my leg day falls on a Tuesday, but this week, earlier in the week, I had a little bit of a break, had 2 days off, recharged the batteries, so we're catching up with the training. So it's legs today. It's basically going to be my staple leg workout, which I do, starting off with the leg curls, superset with a seated calf raises, moving on to squats and so on and so forth. So yeah, but I'm gonna bring you quality movements, quality reps and intensity and entertainment. I also wanna emphasize that Dorian put up a quote on his Instagram yesterday, basically saying that if an exercise or an exercise routine works, stick with it. There's no need to change it and, you know, shock the body and change all your exercises all the time. That's just a myth. Find the exercises that work for you, and improve on those exercises. Get better at them, get stronger at them, and at the end of the day, you will improve. Dorian pretty much done the same routine all the time throughout his career, and he was 6-time Mr. Olympia, but he brought the intensity, and you know, he made adaptations when it was, you know, when it came to things like the volume and the intensity. So if he had to have a couple of days rest or a deload week, he would do that. But in terms of the exercise selection, he'll pretty much keep it the same and keep his routines the same. And that's pretty much what I do. I know the exercises that I like, and I know the routine. I've made a routine that I like, or there's a couple of different routines that I use, but I like them, and I change them depending on the circumstances. But pretty much exercises and my training routine stays the same, and I just aim to improve and to get stronger, and you know, always bring intensity and purpose and intent when I'm training. So yeah, this is the last set on the leg curl, and then I move on to seated calves, and this session will be moving and grooving. I'm gonna bring you guys intensity, and intensity is the most important thing when training. That's paramount. Let's increase the weight. Increase the weight. So we've got 180 kilos on the bar, 4 plates. This will be like a feeler set, so I'll probably do about 2 reps on this to see how it feels before I go up to 200, and that'll be my top set where I'll go all out. So I worked up from 1 plate, actually bar, 1 plate, 2 plate, 3 plate, 4 plate, do this feeler set, and then top set on 200. So we'll see how this feels. Thank you. felt light as shit. Yeah, we'll see what 200 feels like. Starting him up, bro. You good? Let's get 6 reps. Let's go. Come on. Fucking light work. Let's go. Ooh, 4, 3. I'll do a back off set. All right, so top set was pretty shit. I got 3 reps. And yeah, usually I get 6, but I think maybe because I had that break, those 2 days off, it affected my performance. I know I needed the rest, probably more mentally than anything, but when you're in a momentum with training, especially for me, I usually feel good. I usually get stronger and stronger and stronger. Those little 2 days off, I think it affected me. But that's all right, take the loss today. We'll take the loss this week. So I'll do a back off set on 180, 4 plates. Let's see if we get 6 to 8 reps. Okay. Come on. Seven's all right. I'll take that. Yes, Pat. So we're on to leg presses now. Another thing I have to emphasize, one of my pet hates is that people that come on these things load up the leg press and they're doing quarter reps and half reps, mostly quarter reps. I'm wondering why their legs don't grow. Full range of motion, bring the knees down, power up, keep the knees soft at the top, and repeat that. 8, 12, 15 reps, but full range of motion on all exercises, but especially on a leg press, because this is one of the exercises used most for ego lifting, half reps, quarter reps. Take the ego out of it, get full range of motion, and you will see the benefit. Oh. All right. Lunges. Lunges, eight for the faint of hearted. Real shit, yeah, real shit. All right, so, just done lunges. Done three sets. First set I've done 22.5 dumbbells. Second set I've done 30s, then I've done 50s for the last one. Easy concept, light, medium, heavy set. And yeah, now I'm on the last set of seated leg curls. And then I'll do leg extensions and that's it, session done. Lovely, lovely. All right guys, so last exercise, last set. If by any chance you're wondering what this is here, it is, bro, it's cool, man. Bro, it's all right. No problem, brother. It's all right, man, go on. Yeah, bro, come on. If you're wondering what this is underneath my shirt, it's basically it's a hernia belt. I had a hernia surgery in 2022, which was successful, recovered well, but when I'm doing legs and deadlifts, because of the heavy compounds involved and the bracing, I just like to wear it just for extra support in that region where I had the surgery. That's the only reason. If you're wondering what that bulge is in my shirt, last set here. Guys, so that concludes this session. That's all right, I'll edit it out. Not that wire, bro. All right, guys, so that concludes this session. It was a good session. Like I said, basically, this is what I do. This is my leg session. This has been my staple leg session for the last 8-9 years. I might rotate the leg press with pendulum squat or a V squat reverse, but apart from that, that's the bread and butter. That's what built my legs. Heavy squats, heavy compounds, intensity. So, again, I really appreciate the support. I hope you're enjoying this content. I'm going to be doing a video tomorrow with my posing coach Michelle up in Crayford's Weights and Fitness. So that'll be some good content to bring you guys. I'm looking forward to that one. Please, guys, all that good stuff. Like, share, subscribe, and I'll see you very soon for the next one. Peace.